Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at highlights and notes in iBooks for Mac. So let's go into a book here in iBooks on the Mac and let's take a look at some text, and let's say I want to highlight something so I can refer to it later. I can use the cursor here and select text. And once I do that, I get this little menu here that pops up. It gives me several different types of highlighting. I can do some colors or a red underline. Let's just do a standard yellow there. And if I want to change it later, all I have to do is click anywhere in this highlight here and it comes up and I can change it. I can remove the highlight. Just switch between whichever one I want. And I can also add a note, and that'll just create this kind of little post-it note kind of thing here. And I can add some text to it. Now when I click off of it, you can see that the note goes away, but it appears as this box here. So I can select the highlight still, and I can remove the note or remove the note and the highlight, or I can click on the note itself to reveal the note to see what I wrote. Now let's flip through a few pages here and create another note here, just a highlight. Let's just do a yellow highlight for that. And I can go to the top here, and there's a way I can view all of my notes here. I click on this icon here and I can see all of the notes. It shows me the highlights. This is the part that's highlighted. Underneath it, any note that I've added. I also can add a note. I didn't put one initially for this highlighted area, so I can add it right here. And you can see it's going to appear on the right. When I'm done, you can see it appear right here. So I can access my notes either of these two ways. If I had multiple highlights in multiple chapters, I would have chapters with these little reveal triangles here, so I can kind of go through my notes for an entire book, see what I've highlighted. If I, of course, want to jump to it, I can click here on the page number. It'll take me right to where any of these notes are, and it gives me the time of when I made this note. I can also search through the notes, so it'll show me the notes and the highlighted text, and I could search through and find things very quickly. So if you're looking to annotate something you're reading, make some important notes so you can remember things later, this is a great way to do it. Of course, this also syncs over iCloud, so if you're using iBooks, say on your iPad, your iPhone, or multiple Macs, these notes will appear throughout all the copies of your book on all these different platforms. Now this works basically the same way in textbooks. So I'm viewing a textbook, one that was made for iBooks, so it has features in it, like for instance glossary terms here. You can see I can click on astronomy for a glossary term. I can also highlight text just as before, and it will appear in my notes here on the left. And I can do all the same stuff I did before. It's also going to incorporate anything I highlight, any notes I add, to these study guides. So you can see here I've got the study here. I click on that study button, and in addition to five different glossary terms that are already added here by the creators of the book, I've got the area I highlighted, and if I flip the card you can see it uses the note I added. So I can create my own study cards here by simply adding highlights with notes. And the rest of them are actually glossary terms you can see at the top. So they are things that already existed in the book. Two other things I want to show you here. One is that in textbooks only you can use the show notes and margins to actually put the notes over here rather than having them as a little box that you have to click on or having the panel on the side. Another thing is in both the textbooks and regular books you can use the command key and any cursor change to crosshairs and you can quickly highlight things. So you don't have to do the multiple steps to highlight some text. You can just use command and then drag. And you can still click on it later and change the style. Now while it would be nice to have an export option for your notes, you can actually select them, select individual ones or command click to select multiple, and then you can copy and then paste into something else, like for instance text edit. I paste in a text edit here, I get all the information that's been highlighted and the notes, as well as a little bit of information at the bottom.